little tune, right?
Hey.
Turn my voice up.
Yeah.
Say less.
Tired of all the fake shit. Yeah. Tired of all the bullshit. Tired of all these about they gon' do shit. Tired of all these squash shit. You got a problem me, I ain't squash the shit. Say less. 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 Say less.
Squash and shit, JC can tell me do. I'ma tell them no. OGs get on the balls, act like they killers. Most of them hoes. Trenches, I'm like Drake, but I can't count that baby hoe. I grew up a screw up at the heat, the crib up with the stove. 15 roaches crawled up on my face. Diddy probably troll. I get a Grammy, I'm on stage with killers, how I be at shows. No gimmick, I told Pooh he just like Kendrick with a shiesty flow. I used to look up to them hood legends, some mices though. Say less, I had to shop at Payless. For lawyers, you can't pay less. I can swipe off lawyers and for choppers with my Apex. Dirk ain't from the trenches, who the fuck you really say that? Dirk ain't for his, who the fuck you really say that?
Say less, say less. Say less, say less, say less, say less, say less, say less. Man, what?
I ain't gotta talk about it, now I got it, look. Stylists get their style for me, I promise ya. I don't want the bitch if she don't do it sloppy, yeah. We not hearing it, barbarians the big. What's rocky? Her head was sloppy. The fizz on my body, cause my Cuban is so rocky. Living the lettuce for Christmas, even if I'm on my holiday, I swear. For breakfast, she gon' eat me up and swallow me. I'm like, yeah, my ex bitch don't let me, but she still follow me, cause I'm lit.
You ready to fight? You ready?
All right, so here he is, the still undefeated Spaniard, Ilia Topuria. And even before he became the world champion, his Instagram bio said UFC featherweight champion. Self-belief and confidence are not issues for one of the more sophisticated fighters and athletes on this roster. He just has a wisdom and a maturity that belies his years, and that's why even in a matchup like this, he will be patient, he will be calculated, and when a window opens to close the show, more than likely, he'll close it. Rock him, suck him out of the chute here.
Big right hand.
Massive right hand.
Oh, nice right hand.
Oh, that's going to soften him up. Massive knee to the body.
Oh, my goodness.
Big right hand. Oh, huge kick to the leg. High amplitude takedown is true. That was a beautiful reaction to catch the leg and take his opponent down.
Another leg kick land.
Push.
Effective use of the jab there by Ilia Topuria. Oh, that's how you throw a combination. Beautiful stuff there.
What a beautiful uppercut. It landed beautifully. Perfect placement on that shot.
Huge shots there. Oh, a big left hand. Shots exchanged in the pocket there. Slips. Well, his opponent seemed to be stunned to a significant extent, but was able to recover, and it's almost like he let him off the hook.
Kind of let him off the hook. He needed to really put his foot on the gas to try to find that finish.
Nicely done with the kick there.
That was a beautiful hook. It landed perfectly, and it hurt his opponent very bad.
Some real power shots here.
Big right hand. That one landed clean.
Strong outside leg kick. And we got a fight on our hands. Under a minute to go in what has been a wild round one. Well, at this point, DC, I'm not sure if he's just biding his time or just trying to get some extra reps, but go finish him.
It seems like the guy's playing with his food. You know, he's having a good time out there. Everything's working. He's in the zone. It feels like an interesting.
How good was that judo toss? All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Topuria getting work here from the top. Let's see if he goes for a sweep to try to get back to his feet. Oh, so saved by the bell. He was getting grounded and pounded something fierce there near the end of the round. You see it's going to take him a good chunk of these 60 seconds between rounds just to get back to his feet. So a big moment here at the end of the round. We'll see if he can recover in time to make the walk here for this next round. All right, there's the end of the round. So it was a huge strike to the head that stunned his opponent and nearly got him out of there.
Yeah, that was a big moment. A big strike lands.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Round two on the road. Topuria gets caught by that straight punch there. Just missed with the leg kick.
I am starting to lose track of how many punches this guy has landed to the head of his opponent.
Well, the more things change, the more they stay the same. He continues to land a high volume of strikes on his opponent at will.
Well, I mean, John, the guy can fight everywhere, and he can fight everywhere. He's hurt. He's hurt.
Oh, big left hook there.
That leg kick hurt.
Oh, landed some big shots, too.
Oh, he lands a massive kick here. Oh!
Good right here.
Well, now you see some visible damage on the side underneath the elbow. He told us he was going to invest in the body.
And it was perfect. It was absolutely perfect, John. Great placement on that uppercut. Oh, that's big.
Oh, big shots getting thrown. This is absolutely the hurt business. Oh, he gets up. The question is for how long? Big right hand there.
He's mixing up his target. He's throwing kicks. He's throwing punches.
Throwing that jab, no good. Topuria's left leg would appear to be compromised at this point in time. You see he's limping, having a hard time putting weight on it, and it appeared as though it was that last kick that did the damage. Under 2 minutes to go in round two. Oh, beautiful diving hook there. Oh. And back to his feet. Oh, that's a brutal cut on his nose there. He is bleeding. Oh, now lands a kick to the body. Trying to hammer that lead leg.
You better get that elbow down or he's gonna keep blasting those body kicks right to your ribs. Any body kick may finish this fight. It does not have to be the front one up the middle.
Well, a really good second round for him thus far. After a somewhat lackluster first round, he has found a vigorous leg kick, grounds his opponent, moving a little bit, trying to stay upright. But man, that changed the complexion of this fight.
By that one big leg kick. Oh!
Oh! Huge left!
Oh, nice body shot.
Topuria's nose is bleeding now. Looks to be cut perhaps there on the bridge. And the horn sounds on round two. All right, so there's the end of the round. You see the blood trickling down as he makes his way back to the stool. Cut on the bridge of the nose, or so it appears from the strike in that round. Cut man getting right to work. So the crowd voicing its appreciation after that round. We had a knockdown courtesy of a punch midway through. DC, here's your highlight.
It was straight. He threw him in combination and landed that big punch that really did hurt his opponent. Lesser men would have been done. He's got a tough guy in front of him. He will have to go back to this again. He will have to get back to this action if he wants to get the desired finish.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Third round underway. Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to pile up these body shots here in the latter stages of this fight. You didn't see a lot of that in the earlier rounds, making up for lost time here. All right, well, if you like blood, perhaps this is the fight for you. That cut is really starting to open up wide now.
It's starting to open up, but it doesn't seem to be affecting him too bad right now. It's still bloody, but it's not.
Lands another leg kick. Man, it's a long time ahead.
Up. I hit the white rock on the apron with the white towel. Throw it in, boy. My shoulder.
I mean, you got to be kidding me with that knockout. If that is not the number one play on SportsCenter tonight, I'm not sure. So it is the run back between Max Holloway and Charles Du Bronx Oliveira. First meeting was a main event in 2015. It ended less than 2 minutes in. An unfortunate injury for Charles Oliveira. He has prioritized getting this one back. Now in a new weight class at Shelby Dunn.
For so long, Charles Oliveira has thought about getting back. I mean, the fight is going to be over. I can't believe he's still standing. That shot landed perfect.
Oh, who is going to be the last man standing? We're just getting started, and they are getting after it.
These dudes are throwing bombs. This is going to be a great fight.
Oliveira in the world of trouble early. And now some knees.
Oh, he hurt him again, bro.
Well, he's able to get back up here, but oh, man, is he on wobbly legs. In the building, back and forth we go.
Oh, that was beautiful. Big counter right hand. Oh!
Under 3 minutes now to go in what has been a very fast-paced opening round here. All right, so an opportunity goes by the boards. He had him stunned, nearly finished, and now his opponent has recovered.
His opponent recovered. Now he's got to be feeling everything that he had to bring out.
Oliveira's bleeding from the mouth now. A cut there on his neck. That doesn't look like fun. Ooh, looking to go to the leg kick here, just out of range. Well, defense doesn't necessarily win championships in MMA, but he's doing a nice job blocking these shots.
He's not allowing his opponents to get any damage off on him by blocking all these attacks.
There's a kick. Oliveira gets hit by that leg kick. May not be a bad idea to start to check some of these. Well, champ, I don't see that well, but it's hard to miss the redness underneath that elbow. A lot of bodily investment from his opponent tonight.
Yeah, it's an investment, John. It may not pay dividends right now, but the more you go there, the more damage you do, eventually it will show.
Oh, that's the biggest shot in the fight thus far. How's his opponent still standing?
I mean, I have no idea.
Big left hand there inside. Holloway sideways, bleeding from the mouth. Daniel looks as though there's a cut on his lip. Thankfully, he's a lot tougher than I am.
Right to the heels, baby.
If you're the bottom fighter, DC, what do?
You got to move. You got to shrimp. You got to get off on the hips to try to move your opponent off of you or pull him down to close the space.
Oliveira's back in half court. That horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one. All right, that's the end of the round. You see the fighter's got a cut on his lip, not necessarily a Robbie Lawler lip opening, if you know what I'm talking about, but certainly something that could be a source of adversity. All right, so there's the horn signifying. All right, here we go with our second round. It is Max Holloway and Charles Oliveira. All right, so here we go. The crowd on its feet as this next round gets underway. You saw in the previous round, both fighters got rocked. I don't think the scorecards are going to be needed for this one.
No, the scorecard is not be needed. If we continue to fight as we did in the previous round, somebody will lose.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. Still on it.
A sympathizer, me and all my franchises been survivors, sons and fathers, meant for progress at all costs. Any minor setbacks is but a small cause, not enough pressure for me to call the dogs off. I am more the spirit in charge than all y'all. So what is a messiah to a man? You can try and understand what's a lion to a land. I made history, then history began. Black excellence is what we consistently demand. Push your lighters up.
Who's got the Batman lighter? Fuck up the place now. Who's got the Batman lighter? Funk up the place. Anywhere I dare, feel funky.
Feel funky.
Anywhere my people, they feel funky.
Feel funky.
They point the little fingers and they call me the Batman. My brothers and sisters, like we roll under the fat one. To cause back the revolution, this Batman lighter. Change of the nation, this Batman lighter. And it got me feeling insane. And it got me feeling insane, yeah. Yeah. So me, I want high. So I can talk to the most high. And if you know high, you know if you talk to the most high.
Who's got the Batman lighter?
Moon, but can't take off the hunter. I'm John to a Abuja. I could paint an ambiance over the tuba like Peter Luca. Stroke of genius.
You ready to fight? You ready?
All right, so here we are back in one of America's most underrated sports cities. Good to have you with us from Houston, Texas tonight inside Toyota Center. And this is the site of one of your biggest and I know most signature wins of your career against Gus back in 2015.
One of the biggest fights of my life is when I beat Alexander Gustafsson at UFC 192 when I retained my championship. One of the hardest fights of my entire life. The Toyota Center is a great fighter.
Lands a big right hand early.
Drives the shit into the ribs. Great body kick.
Oh, how good was that combo? He is really doing a nice job stringing his shots together now.
And connects with a beautiful jab.
Big knee.
Beautiful body kick. He's trading huge shots. Let's see who's going to be the last man standing.
Oh, big knee to the body. That'll soften him up.
Oh, that right hand barely missed there.
Overhand block there by Pineda.
Big punch land through the middle. Won't take many of those.
Beautiful combination there. If you are teaching an up-and-coming fighter about throwing volume strikes effectively, you can do worse than watching the film on this guy.
It's a master class, John. It's a master class in mixing bodies.
Oh, these guys are absolutely getting after it. Huge shots landing on both sides. Series of strikes for him there, staying busy and staying accurate.
I mean, the accuracy is unbelievable.
Oh, he got him again.
Now he's back up. Oh, nice right hand.
Oh, beautiful combination. DC. I'm not sure how he stayed upright.
I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, to stay standing shows and talks to your toughness.
Well, he rocked him pretty good, but didn't sort of smell blood in the water, and now his opponent's back.
I mean, blood's in the water. You gotta go find the finish. You cannot let him off the hook like that, because now he will be motivated to try to.
Archer, there's the horn at the end of the round. He got knocked down just before the horn, so he'll walk back to his corner here. We'll see if they can get him physically, mentally back into the fight. What a moment at the end of that round. All right, so there's the end of the round. As we show you some of the highlights, DC, and there was a big knockdown there. Thought he might get the finish. We'll see if he gets it in the next round.
Well, if he lands that shot again, it will be over. It will be a finish. You don't recover from two of those types of strikes. He found the right moment, he found the opening, and landed that big strike.
You ready to fight? Ready. Let's do it.
All right, let's get to round two. Well, an appreciative capacity crowd on its feet as this next round gets underway. That previous round, I mean, get the bonus checks ready. That was insane.
It's done. These guys are taking home the $50,000. They laid it all on the line. They dropped a quarter in the middle of the octagon, and they said, let's go. What a round.
Pineda's eye is starting to close up. Got to get that end swell on it between rounds if we get there. Oh, flying knee to the head. Yeah, left hook found its target. Sniff that one out as he blocks the kick. Well, this fight's been pretty crazy thus far. Both guys doling out a lot of damage, and neither seems too bothered by it, but clearly both parties are hurt.
Both guys are hurt. Both guys are fighting beautifully. Both are showing a lot of heart right now in this fight. They're both doing amazing jobs. Let's see who gets the job done at the end of this thing.
Hill going for the leg kick. Nothing doing there. Just over 3 minutes to go. All right, so he continues to land a high volume of strikes. He talked to us a lot about pace and pressure, and he has certainly kept up his end of the bargain.
I mean, the cardio is fantastic tonight. He is pushing at a level that we have not seen him fight before. This is shades of Colby Covington, Max Holloway, those guys that can fight all night. He is showing you that he has done the work in the training room, and it's on full display tonight. That was nice, right?
All right, so perhaps he's gonna have to address something defensively. There is a legitimate cut around his eye.
Yeah, he got cut on the eye from that last strike. He's gotta pay attention now before it gets worse. Big strike. chase down that pin. Oh my goodness.
Well, he continues to do a nice job here defensively protecting the head and sort of maybe letting his opponent gas out a little bit with all the volume.
His opponent sees the target.
Oh, big left hand.
He's hurting bad here.
This is a crazy high pace.
Very good. That's it.
And just misses with that big right hand. All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. Oh, now gets an underhook to get a more dominant position. Oh, judo toss made it look easy. Hook shot attempt to the head here. Instead, it's blocked by Jamal Sweet Dreams hit. All right, so now we start to see some redness underneath the elbow. You got to think he's going to continue to attack the body with all of his strikes.
Well, his opponent has not done anything to deter him. He should keep doing this, keep going to the well. He got hurt again.
Was just a gorgeous shot to end the fight right there. I'm not even sure the opponent really saw it coming, so back to the drawing board for him, but for the winner, this is certainly exactly what he was looking for here tonight.